This is genuine horror. Greetings gamers and welcome back to Top 10 Gaming. I'm your host Connor Monroe and I'm usually not a horror guy, but lately my tastes have been changing. If you're new here, be sure you hit like and subscribe to Top 10 Gaming for daily gaming content and stick around until the end for some bonus content. Recently on the channel we've been doing a lot of gameplay and in reality it's been fun for me. I've always wanted to make actual gameplay videos for a living, but we've been doing some one-off games and we've only played a few EXEs and there are plenty more out there, but which ones are the worst? That's what we're exploring with today's list of the Top 10 Worst .exe games. Roll the intro. In at 10, Pong.exe. The game that doesn't want you to win. This game isn't the worst on the list, and there are so many jump scares. However, the jump scares are predictable. They appear every time you score a point, and all you need is 10 points to win. As the game progresses, the jump scares get more terrifying, and your opponent, which is the game, starts just straight up hacking, making their paddle half as tall as the screen and yours half the size it was, to even warping to the ball if it was too far away. If you think this game is impossible to win, you'd still be wrong. It is possible to win, however, you'll need to overcome major adversity, like if you just got banned for hacking, but you were just being too good at the game. The ending of the game is a bunch of jump scares that lose their fear factor after a few seconds, and you're brought back to the title. And if you lose, there's no jump scare. Just the title screen again. And it's not even like a scary title. What? In at 9, WTF.exe. The name of this game has to be the realest of the bunch. What the f.exe is honestly packed with so many WTF moments. You start off in Lavender Town and that's the only part of this game that looks good. The rest looks like it was made in Microsoft Paint 3D. Yeah, I said 3D. No, the game isn't in 3D, I just think that Paint 3D is worse than normal paint. This game is short and the only reason it has length to it is because you walk painfully slow. It's based off the Uckakip creepypasta and does not do it justice. The environments are a solid color with a red wall and then Pikachu is transparent standing at the end of the hall. The jump scares aren't good and even the player is transparent. They're just an outline. People are not as transparent as this. Come on, I wish they were. Maybe then I would know if someone was trying to flirt so I can tell them to leave me alone. I'm a child of God after all. Praise our Lord Holy Jesus. Number 8, AdventureTime.exe. This game starts off looking promising, but the sprites are really pixelated and you get a character select screen for only one available character. The sound effects look like Five Nights at Freddy's and it is filled with cheap jump scares at literally all times. There are the good EXE games and then there is this. This is the most cliched EXE game. The only time you can make a good EXE game is when it's based off a creepypasta, and I haven't really seen a good EXE game based off an original idea. And by original I don't mean like characters and stuff, I mean story wise. This isn't even considered a game, it's just a jump scare machine. Hell, even Spooky's Jump Scare Mansion has more to it than this. The utter despair I feel when I think of this game makes me feel like I need to hug those closest to me and then apologize for even having talked about it. At least the sprites look custom made rather than just a Google image, and we will get to that later. Later on. Oh boy. Number 7, Minion.exe. Why do the minions need to be an EXE? The incredibly endearing kids movie Minions has to be turned into an EXE. Actually, it's based on Despicable Me, but still. The game starts off referencing Toon Link, saying he's dead because he hates the minions. The graphics aren't the worst on the list, but the walking animation is just feet shuffling. The walking backwards animation doesn't exist. You just glide. The game flashes Squidward, sends you back to the title, and it is so glitchy it's like me when I get less than 6 hours of sleep. The game goes from Act 2 to Act 666, and I'm expecting to see Lucifer pop up and then I have to ask for my soul back. Gru is apparently a mass murderer and he has killed Toon Link as well as all of his minions. The jump scares aren't good, they're predictable and not scary. Like, what is this game even? It's basically Sonic.exe, but with minions and worse gameplay mechanics. You can even hear the same music as there is in Sonic.exe, I just can't, like, why? Number 6, Bonnie.exe. FNAF has so many EXE games and I really don't understand. Why did you make an EXE game of a horror game? The game starts off promising with you playing as a crying child walking through the game. The jump scare is a poorly drawn Bonnie and then the potential gets wasted when you hear Sonic.exe music with the same you can't run bullshit. Then you start walking as Freddy and see a bloody Bonnie. The game fakes your computer crashing, then it fills it with static for the next 5 minutes. Then the game ends. This game wastes itself so much. The potential was huge, but instead they chose to use Sonic.exe music, paint imagery, but combined with actual scary images, meaning they had the ability to access these and they didn't use it, which is a huge waste of time. The game should have only been made when you were able to use all images from like in-game or something actually scary. God! I'm angry! In at 5, SuperMario.exe. No animations, a giant blurry Mario, and the worst Sonic.exe ripoff you have ever seen. Welcome to SuperMario.exe. This game has you floating above the ground. You wait for a solid minute before anything happens, and then it's basically a tableau of Mario killing Luigi, but not like a good tableau. Like only 3 frames. Then you play as Wario, who also gets killed by Mario. The only thing this game is good at is being bad. I can't tell if this game is trolling or if it was meant to be serious. This is honestly the case with every game on this list at this point, but this game is so bad the music literally restarts while you wait because they couldn't get things to work properly. Yoshi literally flies, you guys. He doesn't interact with the ground at all, he can go through it as well. The only way to win this game is to delete it off your computer, or if you want the secret ending, don't download it in the first place. And at 4, ForeverDead.exe. Another damn Sonic.exe clone. Well, at least this one is intentional. This game was intentionally made for the lulz. When you interact with a shadow, but not actual shadow, you get transported into another realm from the looks of it. The sky is red and the grass is dead. The game kicks you out and then the title screen changes. When the game resumes, you are in a red world with a black ground. As text passes by above, you appear as a shadow and it seems like you will become the shadow that you saw. Then they ask you to join them. Then the game ends. This game could have been better if they had expanded the story and made the game longer. It literally takes like 3 minutes to play, and you could maybe get like a 5-minute video out of it if you keep screwing around and then have an intro and outro. The game has potential, but since it was created in 2015, I doubt that we will see any updates now. Plus, the end at number 3, ShrekPit.exe. This game is basically a knockoff Slender, but like a knockoff of a bad Slender game. So an even worse bad Slender game. ShrekPit.exe is brought to us by Kill Yourself, See You Next Tuesday on Game Jolt, and also it's not See You Next Tuesday. If you know, you know. The game is described as a game where you can relive the classic moments from your favorite childhood film as you visit Shrek's Swamp, a barrel of fun for all ages. The fact that even the creator of this game put fun in quotations is something to be concerned by. This was posted over 5 years ago, and in the description it says that Shrek Pit 2 is coming soon, and it did. Shrek Pit 2 Reloaded Black Sunshine Edition is available as well, but it's not really an EXE. But they do add the hashtag it's all ogre now. The original game features layers of gameplay, see what I did there? Like Shrek's Swamp, Farquaad's Castle, and the title location of the Shrek Pit. But this game is only scary because of how bad it truly is. Shrek is love. Shrek is life. Number 2, Gumball.exe. Think Sonic.exe, the one we played on the channel. Now think about that game, but replacing the sprites with Gumball characters, but not replacing them well, literally just placing them over the normal sprites. The title screen still shows Sonic and the Sonic the Hedgehog title screen, not even trying to fake that it's a parody. The sprites are outlined in pixelated white because they never figured out how to properly erase in Photoshop. The standing sprite of this character is just an image of the character with no transparent background, just a block of solid white, and the running animation is just a cluster of balls looking like they made it in KidPix because I literally can't think of anything worse than Paint 3D. If not that, the sprites are just a gross cluster of pixels and the ultimate kick in the nads to anyone that cares about graphics, both in a video game sense and a profession. God, I hate this game. In at number 1, Rosalina.exe. This game? Oh my actual god. This game has to be the worst of the bunch. With the watermark for Game Maker Lite still present, Rosalina.exe has the same grammar quality as me when I'm trying to play a game on this channel. The background is repeating and there are no animations. Then the spelling is so bad it's Donald Trump trying to tweet. And every graphic is made using KidPix 1.0. This game is just a conversation between Rosalina and Mario. It's not a game. This game is so short it's my attention span. Hey, is that a fly? This has to be a joke, right? Like, I can't understand why this would be possible. It's a sin to make this game. You can't even think about making a game like this, or else you're damned to hell the same instant. This is the epitome of horrible content, and I'm saying that with YouTube Rewind and the YouTube channel Fred having existed. This has to be illegal to do something so horrible. This is worse than murder. If you play this game to atone for your sins, you need to go kill someone. I can't. No. No. There we have it, friends, the top 10 worst EXE games. If you enjoyed, be sure you hit like and subscribe for daily gaming content, and comment down below with what EXE game you would like to see us play. And if you see one you like that comment so we know how many of you want to see. Thank you all so much for watching. I have been and shall remain Connor Monroe, and I'll see you in another video. If you're new here, be sure you hit like and subscribe to Top 10 Galing. Galing? Top 10 Galing. That's us. And we've only played a few. Who the hell is drilling? I'm a throw hands. But I gotta wait for my script to scroll. And the game, as the game progresses, the jump scares get more. Welcome to Super Mario.exe. I spelt Mario wrong in my script. Praise our holy Lord Jesus, if I could speak properly. And if you do, it's too late, then the game ends. Why are you sawing? The game starts off words. This is my angry face. To atone for your sins, you need to go kill some. Damn it. I tried to get louder to me. And I'll see you in another video.